I labeled the video wrong, but I can handle it. And I can say, good morning. Previously, we derived equations for inductor capacitor circuits or LC circuits. However, we did not look at any of the graphs. So here is an animation showing all the graphs for all the time-dependent equations we derived, and it also shows how the components of the LC circuit are changing.
That
is a lot.
Yes, it is. So I'll give you a moment to just take it in before we start talking about all the details.
Flipping physics.
That's a lot.
Here we go. Billy, looking at just the capacitor in the circuit, tell me what you see.
Absolutely. When I look at the capacitor, I see that the capacitor has charges on the plates which increase and decrease over time, and an electric field which increases and decreases over time. And the direction of the electric field switches, and the locations of the positive and negative charges on the plates also switch. When both of those are equal to zero, actually you can see how the charge changes as a function of time on the graph. That is the red cosine curve. I like how you put that moving white part of the graph there so we can see where the charge is on the graph and compare that to what the charge is on the capacitor in the circuit. Thanks.
You are welcome.
Oh, and you can see the energy stored in the capacitor as well. There is both an energy curve with respect to time and an energy bar graph. Both of those show the energy in the capacitor in red to match the red charge curve, the red charges on the capacitor, and the red electric field in the capacitor. Again, you can see how the energy in the capacitor changes as a function of time in all of those.
Very nice. Thank you, Billy. Bo, what do you see when you look at just the inductor in the LC circuit?
Sure. Looking at just the inductor, well, the magnetic field in the inductor is in blue and is increasing and decreasing and changing directions just like the electric field. Only the magnetic field in the inductor is at a maximum when the electric field in the capacitor is zero, and the magnetic field in the inductor is zero when the electric field in the capacitor is at a maximum. The current, also in blue, through the inductor increases and decreases and changes directions just like the magnetic field. There is also a blue current graph with the same white part to show what the current is at each moment in time in the LC circuit. Going back to the blue magnetic field in the inductor, we can see that it increases and decreases with the energy in the inductor, which is shown both in the blue energy bar graph for the inductor and the blue energy curve for the inductor. And that purple horizontal line on the energy as a function of time graph, that line must represent the total energy in the LC circuit.
Yeah, blue and red make purple. Nice one, Mr. Pete.
Sure. Nice.
Thanks. Glad you appreciate it. Bobby, nobody has talked about the numbers or the mass spring system. Please discuss what those are.
Okay. All the numbers show the locations in simple harmonic motion where the energy is at a maximum and at a minimum. For example, at position 1, the horizontal mass spring system has its maximum elastic potential energy and zero kinetic energy. Also at position 1, the LC circuit has its maximum energy in the electric field of the capacitor and zero energy in the inductor because there is no current through and no magnetic field in the inductor. At position 2, the horizontal mass spring system is at the equilibrium position, so it has zero elastic potential energy and its maximum kinetic energy. Also at position 2, the LC circuit has zero electric field in the capacitor and zero energy in the capacitor. And its maximum magnitude current through the inductor, maximum magnitude magnetic field in the inductor, and maximum energy in the inductor. At position 3, the horizontal mass spring system has the same energy values as it has at position 1. However, the mass is on the opposite side of the equilibrium position. The same is true at position 3 for the LC circuit. The energy values for the LC circuit at position 3 are the same as at position 1. However, the charges on the plates have switched and the direction of the electric field is reversed. And then back at position 2, the horizontal mass spring system has the same energy values as the last time it was at position 2, only the direction of the velocity of the mass is reversed. This is just like the position 2 for the LC circuit. All the energy values are the same as the last time it was at position 2, only the direction of both the current and magnetic field are reversed from the last time the LC circuit was at position 2. This LC circuit really is in simple harmonic motion, just like a horizontal mass spring system.
Actually, we should talk about the period as well. From position 1 to position 2 is 1/4 of a full cycle, so the time it takes is 1/4 of the period. And, well, that's true between every position. It takes 1/4 of the period between every position. Yeah.
But why is the current negative when the charge is positive?
What do you mean?
Look at the charge and current as function of time graphs. During the first quarter of a period, the charge on the capacitor is positive, yet the current is negative. That seems weird.
Yeah,
sure. I can see how that would seem strange at first. However, it really isn't. It just comes down to which plate's charge we are graphing and which direction we define for positive current. In this example, I have defined the charge we are graphing as the charge on the top plate. If we instead graphed the charge on the bottom plate, the curve would be flipped over the horizontal time axis. You could see that because the charge on the bottom plate starts out at position 1 as negative. Again, if we were graphing the charge on the bottom plate, it would be negative at position 1 and positive at position 3.
Okay, that makes sense. And you must have defined positive current as being in the counterclockwise direction. At the second position, too, the current is positive and counterclockwise. If you had defined the clockwise direction as being positive, the current as a function of time curve would also be flipped over the horizontal time axis. So it really just comes down to which capacitor plate you are graphing the charge as a function of time of, and which direction you define as positive for current through the inductor.
Yeah, that does make sense. Thanks, Mr. P. and Billy.
You are welcome.
Hold up, Mr. P. I have another question.
Yes, Bo?
At position 2, how can the inductor have current passing through it when there is zero electric potential difference across the capacitor?
Oh, yeah. Electric potential difference is what causes current, right? So how can current be flowing when there is zero electric potential difference in the circuit?
Bobby, do you have something to say? Well, take a moment to look at the horizontal mass spring system as it passes through position 2. If we ask the same question of the horizontal mass spring system, it would be, how can the mass still be moving at position 2 when there is no restoring force accelerating the mass, correct?
Sure.
The mass still has velocity at position 2. In fact, it has its maximum magnitude velocity at position 2, just like the LC circuit has its maximum magnitude current at position 2. The mass is simply experiencing zero change in its velocity at position 2 because its acceleration at position 2 is zero, just like the current in the LC circuit is not changing at position 2 because there is zero electric potential difference across the capacitor. The inertia of the mass in the horizontal mass spring system keeps the mass moving at position 2. There must be some sort of electrical equivalent of inertia which is keeping the charges moving through the inductor at position 2, which is the inductance of the inductor.
Oh, yeah. Remember when we were talking about inductor-capacitor circuits? Mr. P showed us that inductance is analogous to mass. Inductance opposes changes in current. Mass opposes changes in velocity because mass is a quantitative measure of inertia, and inertia is the tendency of an object to resist acceleration.
Sure. Thanks.
You are welcome, Bo. Jinx, you owe me a soda.
Dr. Pepper?
Thank you, Bobby and Billy. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.